you're so sick at heart that you can't take part. You can't even passively take part.
Elections in London are just around the corner, and as is the case with many elections in Britain, there is no shortage of some very, very colourful and crazy characters. So let's first give a rundown on the most recent election results, which there's been a recent poll by Comres, which has Sadiq Khan, the current Labour Mayor of London, with a 41% lead. That is very comfortable. I don't think that being just a few weeks away from the election, it can be narrowed in any conceivable way. His next closest rival is Sean Bailey from the Conservative Party. And I'm going to talk a bit about him later. But as you can see, there's a lot of independents. And they have some pretty big numbers. 5%, Nico Milana, Farrah London, 2%. But there's some guys that I really need to talk about because they are hilarious. And one name will probably stand out immediately, Count Binface. And I'm going to save the end of this video to discuss Count Binface because he probably represents the more hilarious side to British politics. So first of all, Sean Bailey. He's a conservative candidate, and first thing you'll notice, he's black. And not only that, he's slightly racist. He's made some comments in the past that have been very critical against diversity. He wrote a study for a think tank where he accused Muslims and Hindus, well, he said that accommodating Muslims and Hindus into British life robs Britain of its community and risks turning the country into a crime-riddled cesspool. So again, you don't have to be white to be racist or prejudiced. And the irony is that these exact same comments have very frequently been said about the British black community as well. So this seems to be the conservatives in Britain, as well as many right-wing parties, they always like to have, you know, the token black guy or the token brown guy or woman to sort of prove to their supporters that they're not racist or that they're not sexist or prejudiced in any way. But then usually the people that they pick for these roles tend to promote pretty much the same kind of discrimination that you would expect white people to do. And there's no shortage of non-whites in the current Tory cabinet. And some of them, if not all of them, are pretty awful human beings as well. Most notably, Priti Patel, who is in charge of immigration policy and is an absolute abhorrent human being. So, you know, don't be blinded by this idea that just because they're picking minorities to big positions like this necessarily means that these parties actually care about diversity and care about giving minorities the position that they deserve in British society. That's not the case. Fortunately, I don't think he's going to win. Like I said, he's been climbing up the polls. He's narrowing the gap with Sadiq Khan, but not at the rate that you would expect him to pull an upset so short in the race, so close to the end of the race. But let's forget about the big two. Pretty much, I think Sadiq Khan has the election pretty much wrapped up. And that's a good thing. I think he's been an okay mayor, not a great mayor. I think he's fallen short on many things, such as knife crime, etc. But he's better than the alternative, that's for sure. So hopefully in the post-COVID age, he can concentrate on the issues where he has been weakest. But like I said, I think he's been an okay mayor, and you know, symbolically a Muslim mayor of a one of the most important global cities is symbolic. Although I'm not the kind of person who tends to appraise the symbolism of the person who's in power, because I think policies matter more than skin color. That's the reason why I'm not a fan of Barack Obama as his presidency. I think he fell short on many things. And I really dislike it when people just point to the fact that a leading politician is of a certain ethnicity or is of a certain gender, as if that in itself made them good people. I think it helps that minorities are put in positions of power, but we want the right ones to be in those positions, because the wrong ones can actually hurt the interest of the very minorities that they're supposed to serve. So now let's talk about the crazy ones. And the first one is Brian Rose. And he is kind of hilarious. He is, he made an ad blitz. I found him, I had no idea who he was. And I just one day randomly started seeing a lot of Brian Rose ads on Facebook. And I had no idea who he was, but I found his promo pics to pretty much give me a sense of who he really is. And that's the look. That's the sort of Trumpian power look. You know, the big red tie, the pinstripe suit in an angle that makes it seem like you have the shoulders of an American football linebacker. The handkerchief in the pocket. Sort of the square face. That looks ridiculous. If you see a guy like this, dressed like this, he's clearly compensating for something. Like, no one who actually has power, wealth, or authority should feel the need to project that in such a ridiculous fashion with the way you look. So just by looking at that picture, I thought it was quite ridiculous. And so I started investigating what on earth London Real was. And it's apparently sort of a self-help YouTube channel or podcast, whatever you wanna call it. There he is. Oh, apparently he claims to be 49. I think in his Wikipedia page it gives his age at 49. I mean, look at that face and tell me that's a 49-year-old. Look at his hands. Those aren't the hands of a 49-year-old. And honestly, if I actually was 49 and I looked like this, I would not be telling people that I am 49. I would lie and say I'm older. So I don't know why he does this. And I'm surprised he even has 2%. I suppose the ad blitz helped. I mean, he's American born. He's not British born, so he has an American accent, and you would think that that's probably a point against you in a British election. But yeah, and he also was a bit notorious because he was arrested earlier this year for breaching lockdown rules, and I don't know what he's he was filming promotional material for his campaign in Southwark on Sunday when police intervened. So there you go. Clearly didn't care much about the law. But he's really funny. And his channel, he interviews a weird array of people, including he's apparently friends with David Icke, who's a famous British conspiracy theorist. And he also invites like boxers and MMA fighters. I think his channel, this London Real channel, is for people, the kind of douchebag who simultaneously wants to be the CEO of a fintech startup and at the same time be like a championship MMA fighter. Like that type. You know that type. And I think that channel appears to that kind of sort of hyper ambitious, steroid-infused douchebag. So, yeah, crazy that he has even 2% of the vote. Now, let's skip Count Binface because I want to speak about him at the end. And let's move to Peter Gammons, UKIP. I don't have much to say about Peter Gammons other than that's probably the most inappropriate name for someone running under UKIP. For those of you who are not familiar with British lingo, gammon was a common insult for people, like a stereotypically white, kind of middle-class right-winger. It's kind of the British equivalent to the Karen in the US, except for men. And the name was... the reason they're called gammon is because it's usually sort of kind of bald, very red. These are people who don't really tan much, and I think the gammons themselves have taken this word as a term of abuse. But there you go. It's sort of that type. You know, very far right, kind of Brexit supporting, middle aged white men with red cheeks. So that's that, and it became a common word during the 2019 general election. So it's very odd that you have the UKIP candidate, because UKIP, of all parties, as well as the Brexit party, pretty much represented this demographic. So having a guy with that name is quite funny. And finally, Lawrence Fox. Lawrence Fox, described here as a disgraced actor, which I think is very accurate, is a former actor who has appeared in a number of series, including Lewis. I've never seen that series. I had no idea who he was before, but apparently he's been on a couple of notable shows. He has become one of the faces of kind of the British alt-right. He started appearing, he made some comments a couple of years ago that got him media attention. He then started appearing on a lot of alt-right channel or alt-light channels. He's appeared on the Dave Rubin Report in the US. I think he's appeared on Fox, on Tucker Carlson, I think. I might be wrong. But sort of that ecosystem of new right punditry. And his plan was to start a new political party, because he's the kind of person who thinks white, Anglo-Saxon, Western culture is under threat by cultural wokeness. The typical alt-right spiel. And he's been wanting to start a party that is essentially the UKIP for culture. Party will aim to represent British people who are, quote, tired of being told that we represent the very thing we have in history stood together against. So, you know, this is basically whitewashing colonialism, denying that structural racism exists, blah, blah, blah. And he's apparently raised a lot of money for his party from, I'm sure, very racist right-wing billionaires and millionaires. And he's running last among, at least among the ones listed here, less than Mr. Gammons and less than Count Binface. And again, I'm going to speak about Count Binface in a bit, but I want to talk about the last loony. And he doesn't appear here, but that is Piers Corbyn. He's also running as mayor. Piers Corbyn is the brother of Jeremy Corbyn, who was the leader of the opposition and twice candidate for prime minister in the 2017 and 19 elections. Piers Corbyn is a very strange fellow. He is basically a conspiracy theorist and an anti-lockdown activist who was arrested famously during one of the many anti-lockdown protests that happened in London over the course of the pandemic. So he's sort of an extreme free speech activist. He's the kind of people who's sort of so far to the left that you're actually spreading a right-wing agenda. And I'm not sure if he realizes this, but that's him. I think he wasn't really discussed much during the Corbyn years. And I think for a good reason. I think Jeremy didn't want to associate himself in any way with his crazier brother. But he's also running in this election, apparently not enough to even be considered among the major ones here. So, as promised, Count Binface. Count Binface is a rather amusing political icon in Britain. He is a... He's a person who has run on numerous campaigns already, usually wearing a kind of like Darth Vader-like uniform. He used to be known as Lord Buckethead, and he famously ran against Theresa May in her district of Maidenhead in 2017. And I think that's when he got a lot of press, because he would appear on stage when all the candidates for Maidenhead were being presented. And I think the whole point was to ridicule Theresa May at the time. But he sort of stayed in the public spotlight a bit. And now he's running for mayor. And he has a manifesto. Obviously, it's a joke. I don't think he reasonably expects to win. But it's kind of amusing. I mean, if you live in London or if you live in Britain... sort of the things he's saying will strike a chord in some way. Well, he wants London to join the EU. That alone would make me want to support him. So I just want to show his video because it's kind of funny. It's a spoof of Huey Lewis's Hip to Be Square. So I'm going to give him some free propaganda here on this channel.
To have comedians run your capital, they somehow won elections. It must be magical. Now my name is Count Binface. I used to be Lord Buckethead. You might think I'm crazy, but I don't even care. Cause now in 2021, it's hip to be mayor. You've seen the other candidates, they're quite a potpourri. To clean up greater London streets, there's no one else like me. I'll give London CFAX, the rest don't even care. I know that it sounds crazy, but someday we'll get there. Let's put the city on the map. It's hip to be mayor. I'm fit to be mayor. It's hip to be mayor. I'm fit to be mayor. It's hip to be mayor. I'm fit to be mayor. It's hip to be mayor. I'm fit to be mayor.
There you go. That is the most English thing you'll see today. And I'm just happy that a guy that's clearly just fucking around, that's clearly a spoof, is actually beating someone from a racist party like UKIP and someone like Lawrence Fox. I mean, and this kind of says it all. Count Binface and Count Twatface. Any election where a guy like Lawrence Fox is disgraced completely is a good thing. And the fact that Sadiq Khan is going to win, that's also a good thing. So here's to Labour winning, and here's for Lawrence Fox disgracing himself evermore. Like every alt-right fuckhead deserves to be.